Radiant Team Ban. Dire Team Ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
All right, now we're back for real. So what's going on, guys? Welcome back to the Dota 2 Champions League Season 6. I'm E-Gadget, and here's going to be Mop Packs, and we got ourselves Game 3 finally. There was a little bit of an epic order issue, but yeah, there's the bans that flew on through. Nothing too out of the ordinary this time, except for the Darkseer.
Yeah, they switched up the order there. You know, mixed it up a little. So that was our fourth ban that we were missing when we suddenly had a little bit of remake there. And so let's see. They're gonna go with the gyrocopter. All right, that makes a lot of sense. And you know who we haven't seen for this whole series was actually the Clockwork. And we did have the gyrocopter earlier though, so. Maybe it might come out here for Fufiongs. I'm not too familiar with my controls. Clockwork obviously played a very nice Broodmother, so I mean, if you can brood, you can pretty much do a Clockwork, right? Come on,
it's like the same thing.
Yeah. then let's see. Remaining. I'd like to see a Spirit Breaker here for new teams. Seems we want the comfort heroes. Get this stuff out. You know, run at them. Winter Wyvern.
Earth. Okay, those two can run at you pretty well. One will blink at you and slam you in the face. The other will just curse you from afar. I like this combo. This is probably going to be an offline Earthshaker, though, and Mr. Wyvern will be coming around a little bit, keeping their safe lane safe. This is a really, you know, pretty common combo. We had this banned out last time, though, I believe. I believe New Team banned it for their first two bans.
Yeah, I believe Earthshaker was banned in the first phase for both of the other games. 10 seconds remaining. So this is the first time he's made his little slip through here. 5 seconds. And they have run it before, and it's always the offlane.
Okay, and they go with their two cores from the new team side. They get the Storm and the Gyro. Looking to not have what happened last game happen this one. I don't think they want to get stomped over this time. They're going to watch out for the stomping themselves. And I mean, we made it to a game 3. It's one of the few that we've had, and you know, this is when all the gloves are off. We get all the picks that they need. I feel like Clock should be picked up from the team side, or Fumfyongs if they want to go for the Earthshaker support that roams around a little bit. If not, then
I'd like to see something that can head into the mid lane really early from Fumfyongs. Like, you already have the for mind control, but then something else like the Spirit Breaker for them is really good for dealing with that Storm Spirit early, putting on a lot of pressure, and it also does help if you can get a ward in the jungle. Very good for contesting those stacks that are heavily relied on from Storm Spirit and Gyrocopter, so you can ward up the Ancients, you can ward up all inside all the neutral camps, the higher camps specifically, over on that Dire side is the most important one.
Dire side is pretty important to keep a ward up on, but next ban? Rubick? Rubick seems like it'd be pretty good.
Always very nice up against the Earthshaker. Winter Wyvern, it's okay. It's not... like it's pretty... I mean, it's nice to steal all her spells, but it's pretty difficult to steal the curse simply because the cast range is pretty humongous. And I don't know if there's any bigger like offlaners they might want to think about banning out, so they've already gotten rid of the Undying. Unless they want the Spirit Breaker for themselves, I'd consider that a pretty okay ban. That's all that immediately comes to mind, though. And you can see the Fata's heroes have already been focused on a lot by a new team, so the SF is probably one of his most popular ones. I mean, the Beastmaster's still up again, though.
Yeah, I would think you might want to go for that again, like that just destroyed face. But I guess the Storm Spirit, it's not one of the better options, and seeing as though he's... I don't know. He doesn't know what supports he's up against either, but I don't think he really cares as a Beastmaster. All right. Well, we should see another support ban here from the Fumfyong side. If not, ban with a Clock or an offlaner, and okay, they take away the Spirit Breaker.
Yeah.
Dire team. And there's
something
the
Beastmaster they're comfortable with. Yeah, so they'll go right into it. Beastmaster also not a super strong laner. Like, ganked, so same concept behind trying to protect your Spirit Breaker. They'll be able to protect him not only with the Earthshaker of Mind Control, simply because, you know, he could TP in and still be effective. Winter Wyvern will be hanging around the mid lane, and you're preventing that famous Spirit Breaker of new team. So I wonder if they'll look towards Goblax Treant again. I could see it being very good for helping with the Storm Spirit, because so far Darkseid is banned out.
I don't know about the Treant. The Treant did like nothing last game, but that was because he was countered by the Iron Shell and, you know, PL illusions, but maybe.
We still have Tusk as well. Must be a Tusk pick for Fumfyungs here.
True. Tusk. I feel like that might be a little too much. I don't think they need Tusk now. They need like damage. They need like good damage right now. Either the AM or the PL, possibly. AM right now actually versus Storm seems like a delicious pick.
Anti-mage.
There it is.
Ta-da! Yeah.
Over here. Zip zap.
So now, still have the dazzle. Something that new team has shown a little bit of comfort with before, and they also have played Disruptor. Too bad, but
wow,
the classic. We've talked about this a few times. So if you actually look at the history, when they've played against Animage, they've only played against it. As far as I can tell, it's only been once, and they also went for the Bloodseeker there. They actually ended up going for the Shadow Demon and the Bloodseeker duo,
okay,
like counter to the AM. So that might be something to look for in the last phase.
I'm really surprised we haven't seen much like Ventral Spirit Bloodseeker, just because of the fact that you can swap them while they're standing still, and they take that range damage. Like, it's crazy. It's like a simple combo to pull off too that guarantees like you're gonna chunk away like half their health. But I can understand with Ventral not being the strongest in the meta right now. And the Shadow Demon, the amped up damage coming in, and the Purge as well, works out really well. I think they need a more direct stun, though. They need something that can lock down. Because there's no way you can just, like, silence them and run at them. They're going to have blinks, they're going to have fissure and getaway and stuff like that. Smart ban of the CM, though. Smart ban there.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely showed its worth in the last game. A lot of the same concepts where you get the Earthshaker, who is very good with the Arcane Aura. And, of course, for Beastmaster, helping keep up the Boris and the Axe spam. Also, it was very good for going up against that Bloodseeker. Man, it did a ton of work. Just being able to hold him in place while he's Bloodraged, not only do you get the damage from the stun, but you can also, you know, stack on some of that bonus damage from any of your melee cores that they clearly already have. So, last pick, what do they have? They have a little bit of time between their reserves.
Reserve time.
Silencer's already there.
10 seconds remaining.
Something for Jerax. He would love to ask for himself, I'm sure.
Clockwork.
Maybe they could go Rubick.
Dazzle.
Get the Dazzle. Yeah.
Okay.
More of a croaky, poor man's hero as opposed to getting a little bit of farm.
Yeah. That's one way to survive the Rupture, though. Although, when you do have them at one health and they're running around, Bloodseeker's at its most effective, and probably killing other people. Probably your squishy supports. So, there is kind of a downside to when you keep someone alive at one health. And new team, what do you got? You gonna get Yoku his axe again? I highly doubt that, but one can dream. One can dream.
5 seconds remaining.
What other hard hitting supports are left with a stun? Man, not seeing Aleen is so weird. Just go with the silencer too. Bane?
I mean, I'm thinking something that's gonna be poor. Like, yeah, Bane's pretty good. Something they played a lot. Sure, they could be going aggro, like they could be leaving the gyrocopter solo, safe lane top, Storm Spirit mid, Bloodseeker plus one off lane, and then the silencer doing pulls for the gyro top up against the Earthshaker. So who could come down with the Bloodseeker? You go a Baden.
Okay, or
pretty intense.
Like, throwing it out there, but maybe Mirana?
Shoot arrow, hit arrow.
Yeah, exactly. That's all you need. Or oh god. Rubick. Okay.
They'll take Rubick for themselves.
Stealing Roar is going to be a big deal here if you can get it. There's actually huge ultis to steal. Weave, Roar, Echo, Curse, Void. Like, getting Grave or Fissure is also a big deal in terms of spells. So
yeah, Fissure's the big one.
Yeah, this is interesting. What do you think? whose draft is better?
Oh, I'm looking at who's taking it, who, to see what they're going to do. So Sadoi's on the gyro again, and he's the one who went aggro last time, so it looks like they'll probably do the same thing and send the gyrocopter aggro. Probably do FN again on the solo safe lane Bloodseeker. That didn't go too well, but he won't be facing the same kind of pressure because we're on the dire side. So Maiden can't, like, jungle and then just walk in and cast spells on you the same way when you're Radiant, just because of the way that it's set up. I'm not seeing a ton of synergy between Beastmaster and Animage. Like, typically when I think of Beastmaster, I think of cores that can act a little bit early, can move around the map with him, pushing your advantage and stuff like that. But when I see this, like, this quad core of these four other heroes without an AM, it's kind of weird.
He bought the courier TP bot, and the courier is now running to base.
The strat, man. It's
ultimate efficiency strat.
Is that a TI5 carrier? Yeah, that is. A little trap jaw. That's a flop jaw. Okay. That's pretty cute. A little one eye. It's like a cyclops. Alright, so we'll see the ward come out early. No one looks to be TPing down bot from NT side, so no real big skirmish going to happen over there. And then he reconnects, and we should be good to go.
Yay.
Yay! What's the, isn't it? No. I'm thinking of duel where it's like, you won the duel or whatever. When you win it, it gets the crowd cheering or whatever. Does it do that? I don't know. Does it? I don't even remember. I don't even play LC. You know when you win a duel, you have the duel going, it's got the drums playing, and then you win, it's like, yeah!
Oh, okay, yeah. More of the Colosseum.
Yeah. Well, they're all grouped up over here. No one from NT side seems to really be having any idea of going into that jungle just yet. And I'm kind of sad we don't get to see Techies again, man. I enjoyed that first game Techies.
I'm okay with not seeing another Techies.
Why? What's wrong with you?
who was that? Who had Techies? The Alliance or whatever? I mean, we had our own cheese with Brood and Huskar. I don't need that again.
Yeah.
But bottom rune, so they're going to look to get this on Fata, but they've also brought the enemy mid, so this, you know, this is what usually results in contesting. Gotta get this on your mid, or it's pretty much GG.
Yeah.
They're just going to send Yoku top.
Really? But they already have Earthshaker up there. And no, oh man, FN didn't come to the top rune anyway. Okay, my control might be in some trouble. He's gonna get the rune. And he got it.
Oh, nice.
No, he didn't.
Oh, no.
Wow, what? Okay, I guess he was still casting Fissure, that's why. Has that,
he
like,
wanted
little
the value.
Animation? Yeah, a Fissure stun and a rune.
He wanted to get, the like, dream. Damage on Yoki, or Yoku as well, but Yoku actually backed in time, and then FN just ends up getting it.
Oh, they didn't drop the courier either, so no fear has to go back to place it. Oh, man. Well, it'll be this Tri versus Tri lane, the aggro Tri lane of NT looking to take down the Matumba Man Anti-Mage. The solo off lanes against each other in FN and Mind Control, and FN's gonna get so much out of this lane. Expect the very early hand of Midas out there.
Huh. So this is a lot like last time.
Mm-hmm.
Except we had a Crystal Maiden roaming up there, so how are they gonna deal with the Bloodseeker this time? They have a very defensive supports in the Dazzle and the Winter Wyvern. Of course, they do have healing, which is great up against the Bloodseeker. And how much can he really harass down Mind Control? That's going to be a big question. You can see he came with 8 tangos because he keeps HP pool high. Looks like they're going to put the... Wow, oh my god, you see that heal?
Yeah, that heal bomb. No Fear actually going to stay alive through the Arctic Burn. Kuroki going to get this last right click. The Salva's going to save him. The last right click to the wall.
The
Go Black. You can see that Thirst was just leveled by FN, so you can get the vision. Wow, and now chasing out a Jerax. Good juke through the trees there with the tangos. And alright, that's going to be first blood for NT123.
Still a juke there from Jerax, so he's not the second casualty of that engagement, but oh, it was so close to No Fear getting killed as well. That shallow, I heard that Shadow Wave is absolutely absurd if you're anywhere near your enemy's creep.
Mm-hmm. That was, what, a 3 creep heal bomb? Wasn't too bad.
I think it might have been 4, honestly, but... So, one less support down here for a while. It definitely puts the hurt on Matumba Man. What's he sitting at now? He's still managed to get 8 CS, so... Can't really complain.
And,
gonna get a lot scarier when FN gets closer to level 6, though.
Yeah, that's when the Earthshaker actually has to sit back and do nothing, because then he just dies from a rush from a silence, and he's like, I can fissure and try to stop you like that, but...
How much damage he's taking?
Oh, it's close to the hundreds now. It's crazy. He does like 92 damage a hit with the plus damage he had. And they can always amplify it too by just getting a little harassed in their lane. That's all, just drop a nuke here and there, you're already adding little bits of damage to the Bloodseeker.
Actually, if you look down bottom though, Jerax has points in the Splinter Blast. He hasn't taken any of the cold burst yet, and he's been trying to get as much harass out as he can.
Silence, gonna get hit by that pure damage, gonna get chased down by FN, he needs two more hits here. And, oh, the Fissure, FN taking a lot of tower damage, he's committing, and he got it. And
no mana for the totem.
The tower, oh, so close! 20 health, okay.
But anyway, they have almost no regen left. So they have the four tangos on Sadoi, and that's pretty important for Sadoi, but there's no tangos or anything on No Fear, there's no regen left on Goblack, and if grass up with the Splinter Blast, it makes it a little bit more difficult for them to come in face-to-face with the Gyro.
Okay. Some man trying to get aggressive there on a No Fear. But, I mean, if Sadoi wants to, you can just pull the tango or two. Like, that's really all he needs to do. But, they're gonna go for the play, they're gonna go for the slow in here. Onto Sadoi, he just pulls him back. Matama Man almost walks into the Rocket Barrage, kind of just baiting that one out of Sadoi.
Also, is dropping low in the mid here. Be careful around those remnants.
So, wasn't Yoku playing one position before? They switched.
I've seen them do a little bit of switching up depending on heroes. So
yeah, I like versatility.
He's been playing mostly the mid lane though. I think in most teams, we had the shuffle, man.
Shuffle. And this Invis rune, go back and pick it up and try to set up for a kill here before it gets denied by Kuro. Eat the tree? Oh, wow. That's a waste of a tango.
Yeah, like, they just played another game, like, just a little while ago, and they had,
Mahone Man getting jumped on Rocket Barrage. They forced him to blink out and get silenced, and Fada was TPing, but he stopped his own TP, and now Sadoi, forced back by the burn. Jerax. Hasn't put any points in Brace yet. Sometimes you go 1-1-1 to start, but he wanted the more nuke-heavy build in the Splinter Blast. Just saying.
But yeah, it's just... I don't know, that's so surprising that despite it being the exact same... Like, it's almost the exact same draft, and it's the same lanes, but Yoki is now mid on the Storm Spear, then the FN... So this is the same as last game in terms of FN being on the Bloodseeker, but in their game they just played last week, they had it swapped, whereas FN was mid on the Storm Spirit, and Yoki... was top on the Bloodseeker, so I don't know.
Whatever, man, they're having fun. They're just playing.
Rare that you see it in terms of heroes, though. Like, usually it might be lanes or something. Or, sorry, it's rare you see it in terms of lanes. I don't know. Same lane, same hero, blah, blah, blah. I'm just gonna shut up about it now.
Jerax,
it's just neato.
Jerax using the burn? Yeah, he's gone. Having Thirst is so cheap. Like, you get them low and they try to juke you out through the trees, and they're like, oh, wait, I'm fully revealed anyway. So it doesn't really matter. And also, Mike Control stuck to sitting in the trees. He's getting XP, which is nice, but FN is getting the gold and even more XP. Like, what
he's
do you do?
He's sitting up here, level 7. He's already bought his TP scroll, because the second that the Radiant side gets anywhere near that tier 1 tower, he's just going to TP down there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's hard with Fata up against the Storm Spear, too, because he has to use the boar to deny runes if he wants to somehow have a chance at this lane. He's actually going to leave the boar to last hit, it looks like. But he can't drop low, like, he needs bottle charges all the time.
What's his bot rune gonna be? It looks like they did find the, such reward, Kuro. Gonna reward that one. Bounty over to the Storm Spirit, okay, help him with his lane. I'm wondering when FN's gonna feel comfortable to just be like, I'm gonna go bot and destroy this anti-mage now. I mean, if I were him, I would just keep taking this free farm. This is the lane for him. He's hiding right now, looking for the TP. But, he doesn't want to wait too long. They're trying to go for the kill on Yoku, it looks like. There's three members currently mid from the Fumfyung side. One Roar and... Yeah, they don't really have any lockdown, with Kuro having no points in Poison Touch. Interesting. So this time around, it's just NT winning their lanes, like... pure last hits and kills.
Yeah, I mean, they went so defensive that they're keeping Matama Man alive, but... there's not really much kill potential down here. You can see Kurogi's now moved to the mid lane. He's trying to get some stacks up. Not sure. See, now he's still going for the same build. Tefata will still only have 2 points in the axes. And honestly, like, that whole stacking ancient stuff, that doesn't really work or Beastmaster, don't come online soon enough. It takes too much mana to do. It takes too long to do.
Yeah.
But we probably won't be seeing any of that.
Laning just feels so much better for a Beastmaster now.
Yeah, but usually you would even go at, like, offlane. You'd go at, like, you know, 9 minutes and you go do your stacks, but that forces you to scale up the axes instead, and the boars are just so good now that you want that maxed out early. So you have the double boars going. Looks like they're gonna go on the top man. He gets tossed back, but he'll have the blink. Jerax is just trying to get some harass out of this Arctic Burn.
Yeah. Arctic Burn does a lot of damage per second when you look at it. It's just taking away for like 30s and stuff. Then with top man getting silenced up, he's gonna be forced to run away from this and take the full silence, so that kind of sucks. But up top, FN getting full fissure blocked, it looks like. They're going to commit the roar, too, on top of this. We also steeping up here. It looks like they're going to get the dazzle as well. Nice little heal bomb coming in as FN running away. Going to drop the silence. Does he make it out of this? Oh, the silence connects on a Fada. They give him the bottle charge over to Mind Control. Can FN run away as a little Bugatti? No! Graphic Officer Mind Control is going to take him down. And he gets a crap ton of gold that finishes Arcanes.
That was really nice. I like the bottling up so that he would be healed, so that he'd run slower.
I mean, Mind Control's already full health, he just needs some mana.
I thought he said he was bottling someone else who was injured.
No, he was bottling Mind Control to give him mana for Fissure.
No, that's not as exciting. I mean, it was a nice snipe, though.
Yes, very good snipe. FA could have ran just straight up and, like, hugged the tree line, and I think been fine. That's... whatever. He still ended up dying. And, look at how low Matumba Man is, even with this, Ring of Regen. Oh, there we go, finally, an Embrace. That's so cheap. It's so good in lane. Embrace is such a great spell. One of the better non-ultimate spells.
And look at
spells.
The pressure down here. FN, like, they're just ready to go. They got the warden behind the tower.
Oh, they see Matumba Man just put on that rupture. And dead. There's the rupture. There's the silence. Matumba Man gonna maybe bait him back a little bit, but either way. Oh, he tried to commit a bit of a mana void there, but. Dropping the call down on top of the Invis Fada, he'll take quite a bit of damage, and they can't dive any further for Jerax, though, which is what they were kind of hoping for, but a big enough kill on the AM anyway.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
I won't even end up getting anything out of this.
Not at all.
The boar just in the mid lane.
Yoku's like, here's his gold. He is.
Alright, so how do you come here as Funfyung's?
Oh, you look for the dive on a Kuro? I guess that's the play. He used Grave early. There's a TP from Mind Control. Looking for the Fissure here. There's Aurora as well. Spada was flanked from the back. Oh. Satoy! Just getting absolutely crushed. Matumba Man's like, alright guys, I'm back. Let's go. Give me this AM kills. And Kuro's gonna steal his kill instead. But Matumba Man should have lasted that so hard. But Kuro's like, no, Shadow Wave.
That was an excellent example of why Max Fissure build is still good. So... although the majority of Earthshakers currently are doing the 2-2-2 in terms of how they're leveling up early on, that Fissure, like, counting out of three heroes, it's ridiculous how much that provides. The damage scaling on Fissure is so good. Rather than keeping it level 2, you're gaining an extra 100 damage output on everyone. And then the stun duration as well. You can even see, like, how much more damage you're able to get off of someone like an Animage because of that. And it's like, it's just some casual dives. Oh, look at Fissure.
Okay, oh, great Splinter Blast. You can't disjoint that. Did you know that?
Yeah, like, you can't disjoint anything.
It's great. Life Break won't disjoint it, it'll just follow you all the way through. Amazing. One of the better spells for getting some nice nuke damage out early. And FN, where's his hand of Midas? Does he have it? No, he needs a couple hundred more gold. Not bad, not bad. So, looking at the 11 to 12 minute Midas, it's pretty good. They're looking for another kill down bot. Apparently Kuro is by himself, while Matumba Man is, I believe, doing like some jungle camps here. And they even TP down Yoku.
Kuroki, okay. Run!
Oh, we got him! Oh boy. They break the tree, he's got a little bit more vision, they're gonna silence him up. He'll drop a grave, I think? Yep, there it is. Delay them just a little bit, but Goblack's still gonna get his intel. And there you go. They give the kill over to Sadoi.
Radiant's bottom tower is under.
And who else is really low? FN moving really fast.
The tower's below half, so this is dead. It did give a little bit of space to Mind Control. He's almost up to that blink tower. He actually just picked up a stick of side chop. So, a lot of value being placed on that, considering how close he is to his blink dagger. Treads are now up, but man, that Battle Fury's a lot farther away.
Yeah, he delays his progress so hard with that build. And look at this, they might find themselves Jerax. Oh no, okay, drops a ward. Safety ward with the Hawk scouting as well. Max Hawk, so good. Such a great... summon. He'll spot them dropping the ward too, so they get the D ward on that. Are they just trying to smoke here? They have the smoke, yeah. Okay.
Thou seest me not.
They see the ward, Kuro. Oh, Kuro almost walking in Yoku. They ping it. Curse? There it
there
is.
There we go.
Do they have enough damage? Even with the heal bomb, I don't think they have enough. Looking for the heal. No, he zips away and the silence is there. Ben moving at mock speed right now, looking to chase down the Kuro, drops the rupture. There is a grave, it'll run with it, but look at this. FN, if you wanted to, you could focus it on the target. Telekinesis is going to stop him from TPing. They get an embrace too, just to delay it. And they zap him down. No fear's like, alright guys, I'll take this kill. Look at that splinter blast damage coming in. Mind Control looking for the fissure. Does he get anything? Anything? No walk out of the trees and try to echo on Yoku? Nope. Okay. And they get away with the one for none.
At first, I didn't even think they were going to have the winner Wyvern in range. I thought Dazzle was going to pop it, so good move by Jarrett to get up there. And they were close, just a little more lockdown there. TPs were a bit delayed there from Mind Control because Mazaz had already ported there. No fear. Come up top and try to close in on level 6 so he can start stealing this blink from Mutumba Man.
Yeah. One of the best spots.
Oh, Mind Control!
Oh, okay.
Just stumbles across low HP. Oh, that's so unfortunate. Sidoe was literally just sitting there, like, doing, like, choke jungling. But they had the Hawk, so... Nice scouting out there. Excellent use there, showing why Beast Meta can be very good. So, that completely pays for the Blink Dagger. Plays can now continue.
And there's the stolen Blink. So, No Fear pretty much... gets a Blink Dagger at the cost of... nothing. Be able to blink around in these fights now.
What a hero.
What a hero, that's great. Stealing spells. Little hooded figure around your town, you better keep an eye out for him. Kuro in some trouble though, gonna get Vortex back before he can get off his grave. No! Actually, Yoku is not gonna be able to finish off this kill, but there's the telekinesis, now he can get it. That's unfortunate. And it looks like No Fear's just been everywhere he needs to be. He stopped like multiple TPs this game. Mostly
like
from
that
Kuroki.
Sixth sense going on. Like, they're not even thirsted or anything.
Nope. I mean, they keep having to delay this game. Mutumba Man, obviously, AM. This game can go on for about an hour. But, really, when you think about it, he built Shreds first and couldn't really afford much afterwards. So, they can try to get No Fear, but no, he just blinks out. Mostly get smoke here? Okay.
A lot of it's going to depend on how Sidoe is going to build. Like, do you go for the helm? You can see Goblax over here. He's doing some of the stacks right now because obviously there is no Dominator. But how do you want to, like, game? Like, what are you aiming for? Do you want to go helm? He's picking up drums right now. Oh no, he cancels. He doesn't even know yet. do you go helm in Titanic? Do you get the SMY? Are you looking. I don't know. I don't think you're going to be getting a BKB. As much as you'd love to be immune from mind control, there's just not enough other reasons for it.
Maybe so, later on down the road, but...
need to make a decision of what they want to aim for with their Storm Spirit. And they already kind of have, because obviously Yoku's closing in on that Bloodstone. Not too far away. And we'll see how the first few fights go, and maybe they'll pick
some. They won't go black. The boars, the axes, and the kill. They're able to get it. There was a TP's coming out from Sidoe. The Necro has been dropped. They can't stop Vada's TP. Oh, No Fear again! I can't. He stops another TP. He still axes, too. No.
Oh, what? Oh, I clicked the.
He's roaring that fight.
He's faster. Radiant's top tower.
And now look at FN coming at 500 movement speed. He's ready to go to get a kill. And get this rune away from mind control. Drop a rupture? No? Oh, there it is. So you drop a silence, force it to move up a little bit. No, actually, it's just a useless rupture. Okay. Zoning rupture is what it is. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Oh, Yoku's not trying to jump in on that. Let the fun begin. Okay. Oh, there's a roar. There's mind control now. Global silence is going to keep him alive. Well played by Go Black. Close.
Benefit there is at least mind control didn't go for the immediate Echo Slam. I don't think that would have worked. Let's see. They do have the smoke up. There's not really a Roche play until they have, like, maybe Necro 3s. It'd be more possible. Or if some man manages to get a little bit of farmies. About 1,000 away. The Battle Fury, so. Could be worse, and Fen's doing. He's going for the immediate BKB. All right, so he just wants to run at them. Midas BKB. Damn with that.
No blade mail? Really? Yeah. He probably needs the health too. I mean, he could have gone for like an SNY and probably done a little bit more damage, but and I can understand this. Even though the roar and the curse go through, like that's if he gets
If he gets stunned, chances are it's being initiated on. Oh, it looks like bottom lane Sidoi gets dunked. Blink
what
echo.
They steal?
Slam jam. Yeah, no, it'll just be the blink again. But the BKB is pretty important for even if he does get roared, they don't really have much else to. Some man's not fat enough yet, and that way it's not able to just set up for Echo Slam, Fissures, Chain Totems, anything else like that.
And at least he has a 17 minute Bloodstone for Storm Spirit, so he's ready to kind of get rolling here. Look for the 18 minute rune, run into a little bit of trouble because there's smoke behind it. Eryx has the curse, he's gonna pop it. Now Yoku, stuck with some Necro units, with the roar on top, with the boars beating into him, and the heal bomb. Oh,
third
man.
Time's the charm. I feel like we've seen that before.
Yeah. Oh.
That time.
And he loses three charges on his Bloodstone, so he's got to work to build those up. We've seen how hard it has been for some Storm Spirits to really get kills, especially against Grave. Game, it's going to be a little tougher to get these kills.
Yeah, Global Sounds will be upcoding though. Oh, nice Fisher block though. And now Fisher stolen though from No Fear.
Well, he's dead. My mind control. Now they're going to look to go for Kuro instead. Nice. They see it, they get the Fissure. And now two more charges over to our friend Yoku looking for another on Jerax. He's like, you guys just killed my fresh Bloodstone here. You're going to pay for it and give me back those three charges. Jerax, does he make it all the way over? It looks like he does. Out of mana though, Yoku can't chase it down. No fear though. Oh, gets the Fissure block.
It?
Is the block? No, that's the block. Oh, it is. Oh, wow. That's like a pixel. Magic pixel.
Oh, and yeah. Now Yoku even gets in here for the Bloodstone charge.
Yeah. He tried to buy
nice
that for it,
by No Fear.
To 8 he goes. That's efficiency if I've ever seen it before. You lose the 3 charges, you get them back immediately. But it's all space. Antimish now has Battle Fury.
At what cost?
Nothing. They even got the top tier 1.
So they have Necro 3.